Zoom, zoom. Airplanes are fast and cool, no doubt. But it's always either too hot or too cold inside. And it looks like those air vents above the seats are made just to blow you away, or at least make you catch a draft. Hey, I'm not a complainer, but I used to shut them tight until I learned it was quite the opposite. A plane cabin is a small, closed space with dozens of people in it. They all breathe in and out all the time, and if anyone on board has the flu or cold, the germs will get into the air. During the flight, you will get attacked by all those bacteria that each of the passengers brings with them, like an invisible carry-on. Small wonder that you can catch a cold or another virus from a sick person. Flu, cold, and a lot of other unpleasant states are air communicable. Just imagine, when you shut the air vents, the germs that get into the air in the cabin stay there around you. Some of them are resilient and can wait for 5 hours or more looking for a suitable place to move in and start thriving. Your nose or mouth can become a cozy home for them. A plane cabin is like a nursery school, where one child gets sick and the other kids get an infection from them in no time. What can you do to protect yourself from that? If it weren't for 35,000 feet above the ground, I would say that you'd better let some fresh air in from outside. But that's a bad idea. Windows on board the plane don't open for a good reason. The only way you can get fresh air during the flight is through those air vents above you. The flow of air will blow the germs away, making a kind of barrier around you. Their concentration in the air you breathe in will become much smaller. Just make the flow not very strong and put on a sweater or a hoodie if you still feel chilly. That way, you don't risk catching a cold. But here is one more thing you need to know about air vents. Like door handles in lavatories, air vents themselves are among the dirtiest spots in the plane cabin. Hundreds of people touch them, but they probably never get cleaned. How on earth can you open them? Don't panic. Just get prepared for the flight beforehand and take a small bottle of sanitizer with you. It'll destroy 99% of all the germs on your hands. Use it after you touch the vent, and don't worry. Here's some more advice on what you'd better not do on board the plane not to get infected. Don't eat the food that has fallen on a tray table. They're not sanitized before each flight, so you can either wipe them with a sanitizing napkin before lunch is served, or throw away that unfortunate piece of scone. You won't save it. Passengers use tray tables not only for food. Babies might sit on them. Some people put their bare feet there. Trust me, they are not clean. Don't use blankets. Pillows and blankets that flight attendants give to passengers get sanitized for sure, but you can never know how thoroughly. And their soft and fluffy surface is ideal for germs. Don't touch the flush button in the lavatory or use a paper towel to press on it. It's the dirtiest place on the plane, which is proved by many tests. So just don't. Don't fall asleep at the window. You are not the only one to press your cheek against the glass. The passengers who sat in your seat before could be sick. If they sneezed or coughed right into the glass, it's full of germs. Again, use a sanitizing wipe to clean the glass and be on the safe side. Wear jeans or trousers and not shorts. Choose clothes in which your skin won't touch the seat. Headrests are covered with one-use tissue napkins, but seats are not. And they're only cleaned if someone has poured out their drinks during the previous flight. By the way, those tissue napkins on headrests hang there not for cleanliness only. Their main purpose is to be at hand in case of an emergency. Passengers can take them off the headrest quickly and cover their nose and mouth. Don't put any food you are going to eat into the pocket of the seat in front of you. Surprisingly, it is the second dirtiest place in the cabin. Passengers put all sorts of dirty stuff there, including food waste and used diapers, and they are not sanitized properly. A seatbelt is another very dirty thing in the cabin. Sure, you can't avoid touching it, but don't forget to sanitize your hands after fastening it and before having lunch. Seats closer to windows are dirtier than those in the aisle. It's obvious, as they are more difficult to reach and clean. So, if you have a choice, you know where to sit. But now that you know all these dirty spots in the plane cabin, just wash and sanitize your hands, and you'll be safe. Another thing that is good to have on board with you is re-wetting eye drops and travel-sized thermal water. Air on the plane is very dry, and it makes your nose and eyes feel dry too. This is another reason why catching a cold during the flight is easier than on the ground. Dry nasal passages are more prone to the germs attack. To make your flight more comfortable and safer, you can wet your nose with thermal water and your eyes with drops. If you wear contacts, don't put them on when you're going to fly. Take glasses instead. Contacts make eyes feel even drier, and if you fall asleep with them, your eyes will be red and itchy after you wake up. Don't forget to drink pure water during the flight. Your throat will get dry just like your nose and eyes do, and you'll need a pint and a half to make up for the loss of liquid. Coffee, strong tea, and sweet soft drinks can make you lose even more water. So it's better to wait till you land and have your latte in the airport. Do you have any idea why the air is so dry inside the cabin? Where does it get there from when you are so high above the ground? An average altitude of passenger flights is between 29,500 and 39,000 feet. The air in this part of the atmosphere is rarefied and cold, about minus 49 degrees. That is why all modern planes have a complicated system that takes air outside and makes it suitable for breathing inside. At the same time, it uses air to keep the engines working, as the fuel in them only burns with access to oxygen. When the air gets in the engine from the atmosphere, it gets pressed and heated. Part of it is taken for breathing in the cabin. It happens before the air gets mixed with the fuel, but it goes through a filter anyway. The temperature of the air after it comes from the engine is about 932 degrees. Too hot to breathe, right? That's why after that, it is sent to a heat dissipator where it gets cooler. Then it goes into a cooling turbine where it gets even colder and at the same time runs a plane turbine. So there are two air flows that get into the cabin, a hot one that has not been sent to a heat dissipator and a cold one that has come through it. The pilot controls the air temperature in the cabin, mixing the two flows. The main flaw of this system is that the air that gets into the cabin is too dry. It is already dry enough outside and gets even drier when sent through all the filters. Now this is done on purpose. If the air is too wet, air conditioning system may get stuck with ice. Remember, it's cold outside, and any moisture will freeze immediately. So, we better put up with dry air on board. So, let's stop here and think. To avoid all the potential germs and illnesses introduced into the cabin by those other passengers, and to protect myself from the ill effects of the dry air, next time I fly, I think I'll wear a hazmat suit. You think they'll let me on the plane? Let me know what you think down in the comments. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right. And remember, stay on the bright side of life.